oftentimes storytelling
the suffering gives way to other voices. One gives way to the urban burdens of this world. One gets way to pessimism. One's heart becomes critical of everything. One begins to look for the worst in all things, look for the worst in all people. But then one gives way to the unrelenting spirit that is attempting to turn one's heart towards selfishness, fear, blame, and indifference. And this is precisely why I ask you to pay attention to those who are simply watching, to those who were simply witnessing. Because they were there, I guess they weren't there. They saw all the crucifixion of Jesus and remained silent. They crucified him because they did not know him. They didn't want to know him because knowing him meant not only confronting the powers of Rome and its leaders and its kings, but even more, in that going against the very power of evil, against the very unjust system of antiquity. Thus the sign that says, this is the King of the Jews. Neither the Roman leaders nor the Jewish leaders wanted to approve or condone such a sign. But what they did not comprehend, and by the way, what many today cannot comprehend either, is that Jesus is no earthly king. But Jesus is a heavenly king, a holy servant, a sacrificial leader, hanging on the cross, and yet still hanging on the cross, offers forgiveness. Forgive them, for they know not what they do. Still offers compassion. Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. Still offers love. Father, into your hands I entrust my life. Those were the three sayings of Jesus from the cross. But see, I guess what I'm submitting to you this morning is that when the unrelenting spirit wants to turn your heart to bitterness, when that unrelenting spirit wants to turn your heart to indifference, to blame, to the guilty burdens of this world, that when that happens, one cannot remain silent, one cannot remain just watching and witnessing, but one must act. One must look to the way that Jesus, despite suffering, despite impediment, still offers forgiveness, still offers compassion, still offers love. Now, it's interesting that Jesus also, in the midst of all of that, not only is he offering these things, but clearly understands that for such things like compassion, like forgiveness, like love, that those gifts are not just human decisions we make, but that also depend on gifts of God, depending on God. And perhaps you've been trying to love someone. You've been trying to forgive someone. You've been trying to show compassion to someone, and you've been doing it all on your own, without realizing that to do such things, those are the ability to love, to have compassion, to have forgiveness. They are gifts that come from the divine. But those are gifts that we ask for. This is why Jesus says, forgive them, for they know not what they do. But also, for, you know, maybe you're not ready to forgive, maybe you just say, God, forgive him, forgive her, forgive that them, forgive that group. Forgive that church, forgive that pastor, for they know not what they do. Jesus is the gift from the divine, given to the world, who has come to this, to come to this world to die on the cross, to take away our sin, our failures, our mistakes, our burdens, our transgressions, our inability to forgive, our inability to love. I mean, what if this passage is about teaching us how to be human in 2022? Do you not believe that what's needed in our times today more than ever before is more forgiveness? It's more compassion. It's more love. And Jesus things, to give his life for such things, to embody such things for this world, and yet offers us forgiveness, redemption, love, grace, renewal. And then he rose on the third day, this day that has become the omega point of history, who Jesus is the reality of this resurrection, of this liberation that we all get to live into today. Because we do realize we're liberated, right? To lead differently, to love differently, to direct life differently. Right? Because Jesus is not your common earthly leader, but has come to show us a better way to lead, a better way to direct, a better way to guide, a better way to be driven. And if in this time we are called for such things, then this passage becomes so much more than just scripture. Don't be positive.